Hi guys, Adam from New Horizon Code here, and today I'll be teaching you how to generate verification tokens on Syrup. This gives you a unique and customizable way to verify your users before they complete the signup process. So to get started, I'm going to go ahead and show you the current flow we have. So I'm generating a random user here, and I sign up. Then show me a token. This is unique to each user, and I have to verify this. Once it is verified, I'm now able to log in. So the way we do this, guys, is fairly simple, but there's a few key steps you must master before you can get this going in your application. So when a user signs up, we simply sign them up with these values. We create a verification key. That verification key is just a token, and it's a random string that we generate, 6 characters long, and we use letters and numbers to make it a little bit more unique. After that, we schedule a workflow to delete the token. We do this because we have a new data type called verification key, and we don't want to overcrowd that if users are generating accounts and then they're not following through with completing the signup steps. So 2 hours after this has been triggered, we'll automatically delete it just to sort of keep our database nice and tidy. We'll then make changes to our verification key, which we just generated in step two, and that is capturing the API ID. This is handy because when we finally verify the user, we can go ahead and delete everything and delete that API workflow to, again, free up some sort of space in our application and keep everything as neat and tidy as we can. Next, we're going to go over verifying the user. So to do this, we firstly run an only when condition, and this is only when the verification keys that we're going to be searching for relate to the current user. So related user, which on our data type here is a user, is equal to the current user. We want to look for the first item that shows up. We want to check the token is, and then the input's value. And that input, again, is just here. So once that's correct, we firstly cancel our API workflow. And we stored that in our signup process, so we can go here and enter that API ID, and that'll set that up. We then delete the verification key. So that's that data type. Same sort of search, although this time we're checking the token and we're taking that from the input and verifying that as well. And again, we take the first item. Finally, we just have this logout step, but that is just for us to show you how quickly it works. So you can skip this step. One step we would recommend is once this is verified, we'd make changes to current user. And we'd probably generate a new field called verified. And this will just be a Boolean value, yes, no. So once this is complete, they're now verified. So let's try that again. One more thing we'll change, just for ease of use, is by default this will be no. So this will take a few seconds to refresh. We'll then sign up here. As you can see, we now have an account with the token. If we go to our data types and go to here, we'll see we are no. We will then take this verification code, enter it, verify our account, and we can check here that when we refresh this, it is now yes. Hope this video has helped you guys understand some basics of verification, and if you have any questions, leave a comment. As always, you can book your Bubble training session at bubblelessons.com. Have a wonderful day. Goodbye.